एस्टेट प्लानिंग इज़ वेरी वेरी क्रूशियल एस्पेशली फॉर यंगर पीपल. प्लीज़ हियर व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. एस्टेट प्लानिंग इज़ वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट एस्पेशली फॉर यंगर पीपल हु हैव लोन्स लाइक एजुकेशनल लोन्स और इवन लोन फॉर प्रॉपर्टी. Because you, if you're not very careful, the assets could be with somebody and the liability could be with somebody, and it could be a longish legal process to be able to sort it out. So that should not happen. For example, if you have a student loan, let's say you're a doctor or maybe you're an MD and you've spent a lot of time in your education and all this has been funded by your father. And your father has taken a loan, or you have taken a loan, and your father has guaranteed this with a loan because he has a house, right? So who is the guarantor of your loan? It's your father. Who is the actual person taking the loan? It's you. And you have some assets, and you're already got married, right? What could happen is, let's say you have a term insurance and in which you have made your wife the nominee because you have taken a house. Now this would be a terrible thing to happen because you would be dead and the house would belong to your wife because she would have got the term insurance proceeds and repaid the home loan, and therefore she would own the house, which is rightly so, but your father would be stuck with a huge liability of your educational loan. Right, so you have to be very careful while doing your estate planning for a younger person. Let me repeat, for a younger person. For an older person who is say 80 years, the next of kin will have a problem, yes, because some of his assets, he may be real estate on which he has not put a nominee or he has not written in his will, and there is a problem from the local authorities like a CIDCO or a BMC. But for a person who is young, there could be a big problem because assets could go to the wrong person or assets could go to another person and liabilities could be stuck with another person. So you have to be very careful while drafting your while doing the documentation of your estate planning. Now, estate planning is not just about writing a will. It is also about writing a living will. What happens if you are in coma for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years? What kind of medication do you want? What kind of medication do you not want? Or if you are not in a position to decide what medical treatment you want, who is the health agent that you appoint who will be handling it on your behalf? Please understand that a living will is today seeing some reality in India also, right? There is some traction. Lawyers, judges, etc. are talking about it, right? It has not happened, but it is, people are talking about it. People are writing the living will. The courts will consider a living will on the basis of some sense, saying what happens if there is no living will, right? So all these things will happen. So we have to look at those things. So in this estate planning thing, we will see what is estate, what is planning, what is estate planning, what is writing a living will, what is writing a will, right? This whole combination is estate planning. It is not just writing a will. Writing a will is the easiest part because you know who are the beneficiaries, you know who should benefit, so you could write it at home. Maybe you get it notarized or maybe you even get it registered. Those are at least optional. But it is absolutely not optional that you write a will, right? But this whole process is estate planning, and we will see this estate planning in greater detail as let's call this was session number one. So this is estate planning 101. So we will do further sessions on that. Thank you.